What can compete with the aroma of fresh baked bread?
The smell of bread makes people happy, I believe.
In 2016, Nobuko Maruyama opened Koko Bakery in Newton, named after her beloved Shiba Inu. Trained in her native Japan, Maruyama began baking for one reason, baguettes.
I really like to eat baguette. One day I started to think about how to make it. That's my motivation.
Lucky for the rest of us, these artisan pastries, all Japanese, French, and German, are baked to perfection by Maruyama and her staff. Specialties include fruit danishes, creme brulee toast, and cream pan, a roll with a soft custard interior. Also made here, savory pastries filled with beef curry or corn and cheese.
Most of the day, I'm working from early morning to evening. Over 12 to 14 hours.
The Koko team bakes dozens of different items daily from scratch with no preservatives. Some breads take more than 40 hours to make.
I don't want to use any chemical stuff, so our bread and then pastries not last long, but always fresh.
Also from the good news files, Japanese pastries have less sugar than their Western counterparts with lighter, fluffier textures. Still, some items like this chocolate croissant are decadent.
We have a lot of chocolate inside, so I don't think it's low calorie.
Chocolate, of course, is a staple ingredient in all kinds of desserts, including the often whimsical-looking work of Walpole, New Hampshire-based L.A. Burdick. Here at their shop in downtown Boston, we meet head chocolatier Michael Klug. He demonstrates tempering, a process that gives chocolate its even color, shine, and smoothness. At their New Hampshire headquarters, L.A. Burdick's bite-sized chocolates are handmade from start to finish.
In the holidays, I once did a count. We'll do average in December 80,000 pieces a day by hand.
Getting textures and flavors just right is time-consuming and exacting.
Chocolate offers also so much flavor richness. The sugar should carry, but not overpowering. You should have layers of different associations, if it's like dried fruit, nuts, or bananas, or coffee.
Klug, who was trained as a savory chef and pastry chef in Germany, thinks there's a reason people prefer sweet treats after a meal.
It's very hard for the palate to go to more like savory notes after a sweet. So I think naturally, therefore, the sweet thing is something that is placed at the end.
I like doing something that puts a smile on people's faces. People are always excited to see dessert.
Every day, Valerie Nin fulfills dessert dreams.
We have 300 desserts in-house, and we have 12 desserts on our menu. Probably half of them are custard-based.
Nin is the executive pastry chef at Grill 23 in the Back Bay. Custard is her specialty.
The basic ingredients of creme brulee are heavy cream, egg yolks, sugar, vanilla. Sometimes the most simple is the most delicious. Custard is liquid thickened with egg. Pudding would be liquid thickened with something that is an egg. I love custards because they are the base for a lot of pastry, like mousses and bread pudding and ice cream. Like, custard is the delicious undercurrent of a lot of dessert.
Among Nin's many creations, coconut cake with dulce de leche, caramel profiteroles, and almond shortcake with buttermilk ice cream. And then there's a cool weather classic.
As soon as summer is over, I'm like, it's bread pudding time. I'm gonna make a challah bread pudding. It's got caramelized milk chocolate in the middle and brown butter on top and a cinnamon custard.
Bread pudding was created as a way to use stale bread. At Grill 23, Nin uses fresh bread left out overnight.
It's nice to let it sit out to lose a little bit of moisture, because you want it to absorb all of the flavorful custard that you're going to pour on it.
Dessert making is Nin's happy place. She's known she wanted to be a pastry chef since the eighth grade.
A couple years later, I was in high school. My mom was like, you should get a job if you want spending money. And I was like, okay, I want to work in a restaurant. So it all went from there.
So many pastry chefs that we heard from mm-hmm. say that the pastry department is usually much calmer in the restaurants.
Yeah, Valerie from Grill 23, who you just saw, says that generally pastry chefs, they work alone or in small groups. They tend to be super organized, mm-hmm. lots of lists and charts and sort of everything in the same place every day, a lot less chaotic than the rest of the kitchen usually is.
So are you a savory or sweet?
I'm both. I'm hungry right now.
All right, and now for something completely different.
Green apple with dill, pistachio with orange blossoms, coffee with figs.